आची नोति जो शास्त्रार्थम आचरे स्वयं आचरति अस्मात् आचार्यस्तेनो कृत्यता। आची नोति जो शास्त्रार्थम स्वयं आचरे स्थापयति अपि स्वयं आचरति अस्मात् आचार्यस्तेनो कृत्यता। श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू इलेक्ट वन आचार्य थ्रू इलेक्शन। श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद टोल्ड इट इज नॉट एट ऑल पॉसिबल टू इलेक्ट एन आचार्य थ्रू इलेक्शन। इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल। परहैप्स फॉर दिस रीजन जगद्गुरु भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद डिडंट फील इट नेसेसरी टू इलेक्ट एन आचार्य फोर्सफुली। लॉन्ग एगो आई मीन एट लीस्ट 15 ईयर्स एगो वन गौड़ीय वैष्णव आचार्य आई डोंट लाइक टू स्पीक हिज नेम ही वॉज ओल्ड इनाफ ही वॉज स्पीचिंग इन डिफरेंट प्लेस इन फॉरेन कंट्री हियर देयर very strong acharya. Some of his devotees, they approach his Gurudev and request him, Gurudev, you are aged enough, so for if you cannot take any action about who will be our future acharya, under whose guidance we can stay, you will have to, it is our request to you. For some time, Gurudev keeps silence. After that speaking, I don't think anybody who is just qualified. So what to do? Then some devotees, they are speaking. Then Maharaj, your mission can break down very swift, very quickly. Very shortly, your mission can break down. Then Gurudev shouting, well, if it is by the desire of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, this mission I established, if it is breakdown by his desire, still I permit, okay. But still I cannot elect any acharya who is not just qualified. It's not possible. Those who are very senior devotees staying here, doing Vaishnava association, doing Vaishnava Seva for a long time, for them it is not new that to serve Vaishnava and to take service from Vaishnava not same. Those who are senior Vaishnava staying here, they knowing it for long time, this factor, we can serve Vaishnava at the same time if our mood is just negative, we can take service from Vaishnava, from deity, Gurudev, Vaishnava bhog. In Bengali and Sanskrit we say to bhog, we can enjoy Vaishnava, his reputation. If I stay with Vaishnava and I can identify myself as a pure devotee, I am serving him, this way I can get reputation in future, I can get, you know, so much pratishtha. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, that's why Vaishnava, who is Vaishnava in his writing, clearly speaking, Kanaka Kamini Patishta Bhagini Chariya Chejare Seito Vaishnav. Who is Vaishnav? Now Kanak Kamini, all material, Pratishta, money, position, rank, automatically gone away from the life of a devotee, he is actually Vaishnav. I cannot say this way, I already leave Patishta, money, everything, not possible this way. Chariyache jare, I have, leave everything, it's not possible, it is one kind of false ego. This way I cannot express. Actually, point is that Vaishnav K, in this, writing, Prabhupada clearly speaking, who is Vaishnav, who is not. Sometime it is seen that those bonded devotees, bonded soul, they have some, this kind of audacity, they can pass this kind of remark, he is Vaishnav, he is not Vaishnav. But actually, Papa speaking, you have no right to pass any kind of remark because you are bonded state. Those bonded soul, they have no right to pass remark about Vaishnava. They cannot pass any remark. You see. Now point is that who is Vaishnava, who is not, how to distinguish, how to identify, because we all are in the uniform of Vaishnava, sannyas, brahmachari, grihastha, we are all Vaishnava, tilak and mala, everything. How to identify? Prabhupada speaking one nice way through which you can identify readily, he is Vaishnava, he is not. How to identify? Prabhupada speaking, if you watch that those devotee, they are shouting, Jai Gurudev, Jai Gurudev, Jai Gurudev, Jai Prabhupada. But if you find they are all going against pure Vaishnava, their activities, readily you can detect they are non-Vaishnava. They are not at all Vaishnava. Surely they can go against pure Vaishnava, fight against Vaishnava, their Siddhanta, their acharon, they can detect some fault with them. Then you can readily understand that he is not Vaishnava. Not Vaishnava. Today, I am very lucky, I feel myself very lucky to attend this kind of function. My Sikhya Guru Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, how you can understand that he is a great Vaishnava? Some people can say, no, he is not Vaishnava, he is Vaishnava. How you can understand? What is the procedure? Actually, through his seva, through his guru seva, you can identify Gurur anugrahen naiva pumana purna prasantvai. First slok, I already told, I think I have no time to explain it, but still I would like to explain something. In dasam 10th canto, there is written Gurur anugrahen naiva pumana purna prasantvai. You can get total tranquility, you can attain peaceful position, 100%, when you are enjoying full Guru Vaishnav Kripa. Otherwise, not possible. Otherwise, it is not possible. That's why in Chaitanya Charitamrita it is written, Krishna Bhakto Niskam Atev Santo. Krishna Bhakto is no desire. That's why he is peaceful. He can speak Siddhanta, because Siddhanta automatically coming inside your heart, flourishes inside your heart. He is not going to manufacture any Siddhanta, automatically coming. So, Gurur anugrahen naiva pumana purna prasanda naiva mean affirmative. There is written affirmative, it is 100, know it for sure 100%, that if you are enjoying full Guru Kripa, then and only then you can become peaceful. Otherwise, to do bhakti is not at all possible. Judgment of bhakti is not at all possible. Bhakti, different kind of bhakti. I have no time to discuss this point. And the first slok from Vayu Puran, you already know, sometime you discuss. Achi noti jo sastvartham achare sthapayati api swayam acharate yasmat acharyo steno kirtita. Here is one vital point, sthapayati api. Very vital point. Bhaktivinoda Thakur sometimes speaking in his, you know, speech or writing, that those who are entering into a, you know, bhajan kutir, they like to put prove that we are great Vaishnava, we are doing Harinam. We are not fighting with anybody. They like to prove we are very, very big Vaishnava. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, those who are going in preaching field with acharan, they are more elevated than them. Because anyway, to establish Siddhanta is a vital thing. Yesterday, I was trying to discuss this point. The vital point, this is the most vital point. Actually, the duty, the main duty, the vital duty upon Acharya is to give full protection to Siddhanta Bani. If you can give full protection to Siddhanta Mani, then everything can be protected. And also, I told you that Siddhanta and Seva almost same. Why almost same? When Siddhanta you can find in applied form, you can see it is Seva. When you are speaking any Seva, if I can catch through Siddhanta, it is all the same. vice versa, no problem. So actually, there is that first sloka I started with, that I told, Stapatiopi. Maybe some Vaishnava have acharon. He is doing acharon. Gaurkisar Baba, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, they are all established in acharon. But still, some vital point is there with Gaurkisar Baba, speciality. There's Gaurkisar Baba, though not going for preaching field, in preaching field stool, still he is speaking some vital siddhanta, many times, protesting. Very vital point, Gaurkisar Das Babaji Maharaj. So actually, first of all, before going to preaching field, you must get established in acharon. That is vital. Otherwise, you have no right to go in preaching field. Totally, if you are established in acharon, then and only then you can go to preaching field, otherwise not. Now, point is that, if acharon is there and preaching is there still, preaching power is there, still he is not going for preaching, then what problem? Actually, Haridas Thakur and Sanatan in Purushottam Dham discussing these two points. There, Haridas Thakur, Sanatan Gosai is actually praising Haridas Thakur. You are Nama Acharya, bigger, you know, you are topmost. Yeah, you are the personal associate of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Then Haridas Thakur speaking, actually you are most important personality because Gauranga Mahaprabhu giving order to you to establish all Siddhanta and to, you know, to discover all those secret places of Leela Sthali. So you are most lucky. Then they are discussing, actually Sanatan Goswami is speaking, somebody doing acharan, not doing prachar. Somebody doing prachar, having no acharan. But you are most important acharya. You are doing both acharan and prachar. You have with you. So I think you are the most important acharya. Achar kare keho na kare prachar. Prachar kare keho na kare achar. Achar prachar namer karo dui karjo. Tumi sarva guru, tumi jagate rajyo. Is the topmost. Now another vital point with Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj and all other, you know, those who are established acharya, this is the vital point. Bhakti Ballabh Puri Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, Srila Bhakti Madhava Goswami Maharaj, their acharan is very powerful. Because through acharya, they can inculcate total Siddhanta or in Baba inside the heart of bonded soul. This way they can deliver, emancipate all bonded soul. Otherwise not possible. Otherwise it is not at all possible to deliver bonded soul. This is the vital thing. You will have to follow all Vaishnava etiquette. At the same time, you should have your power through your acharan. You have the power to inculcate that Vaishnava etiquette, Vaishnava Siddhanta inside the heart of our bonded soul. Otherwise, you have no power to act as an acharya. You see, this is the most vital thing. And he is practicing acharya. That's why he is acharya. Who is not practicing acharya, he can, through negative preaching, he can, you know, it will make all problem. Because preaching can be done both way. One is positive way, another is negative way. Positive preaching is only possible by those who are positive devotees, pure devotees. Like, actually pure devotees, those who are, through them, positive preaching can be possible. Otherwise, for bonded soul, preaching is not possible. And positive preaching and negative preaching, positive preaching is very slow but yet very steady. And it has some deep preaching effect inside the heart of our bonded soul. But negative preaching, like I can give example, Agasur, Bakasur, Putana, you know, Kamsa, they are Jarasandha, they are all doing negative preaching from Krishna. They are all doing negative preaching for Krishna. Because negative preaching is very fast. So actually, Hanumanji preaching for Krishna, preaching for Ram actually. But Ravan, his preaching is more fast, faster than Hanumanji. So this way actually, negative preaching and positive preaching you should keep in mind. Otherwise you see the condition of a present Vaishnav society, all senior Vaishnav gone, we are all crying. We cannot see any, any vital, vivid example. Until and unless one bonded soul can see a vivid example in front of his life, he cannot get power to do bhajan. There is a big problem. They cannot do bhajan. You will have to follow and see. He is a big acharya, his acharon. If you stay under his guidance, then and only then it is possible for you to preach and do bhajan itself. Otherwise not possible. In the life of Prabhupada, in the life of Keshav Goswami Maharaj, they are always speaking about positive thing, actually positive thing. That's why they are always and every time they are facing some kind of confrontation. Every time problem. You see, Prabhupada speaking Harikatha positively, then all Sahajya Babaji, they like to kill him. If we find him outside, we can kill him. This way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur in Puri Dham, advising you, well, you do one thing, you go to Navadip Dham, Mayapur, and do bhajan there, Harinam. After that, I can advise you something. Do Harinam Jagga. This way. And in Poramatala also, those Sahajiyas, they are attacking, Gaudiya Vaishnav to break their head. This is one kind of positive preaching, actually. Some devotees told, we can go to court and file one case. Prabhupada said, why? But they are doing this kind of mischievous activities, but they are doing very positive thing, because we have no money power, nothing. We cannot do big preaching. So you can see next day all in newspaper, in radio, everywhere, our Gauriya Math, this preaching going on. So they are doing a positive preaching for us. Why you are, thinking this way? Always try to think positive way. Though they are preaching negative way, the Prabhupada speaking positive way. Actually, Srila Bhakti Ballabh Tirtha Goswami Maharaj, he took birth in, Assam, Gwalpara. There, very nice devotee from its childhood. I wrote one book by the order of Vaishnavas, Kono ek bastav sit tirthe sandhane, in search of a pure pilgrimage. I wrote one in which I got some information, nobody giving total information. I collected, nobody giving diary, nothing. Anyway, in the year of 50 years completion of his sannyas vow, Brato, I published this one, very, very small treatise actually. There I wrote actually, Maharaj, from very childhood, he is growing Vaishnav Seva mood and bhakti from very childhood. One day, Maharaj coming back from school, he watching in one house, there is one saffron color cloth drying in roof. He watching, why? He entered the room. Any Vaishnav coming inside your room? Yes. I like to take darshan. No, today, not now actually. He is doing some seva. Maybe afternoon time you can come. Both you can take darshan. You can have the chance to hear Harikatha. Better you come. Well, I can come, of course. Then when he coming and attending Bhakti Daita Madhava Goswami Maharaj, he is surprised. How is possible so long? Ajal unambita bhujo. So nice appearance. At first sight, he sell himself unto the lotus feet of Srila Bhakti Ballabh Madhava Goswami. He took resolution, I must go with him. I cannot stay in home. I can complete my education and go with him, and readily. By that time, I think, after that he completed graduation, post-graduation, Calcutta University. After that, he totally dedicated unto the lotus feet of Madhava Goswami Maharaj. If I go on speaking about his seva mode, you can go mad. I have no chance, time is very limited. Also, I will have to go to my mot, there is also function. I will have to speak something, though I don't know how to speak Harikatha. So I will have to go there. That's why I cannot speak a lot. So many points actually, seva mode. Actually, all day and night, without any personal benefit, personal interest, he is doing all day and night doing seva. Whole day and night, you cannot even imagine. When he took the post of Acharya, he never liked to take the post of Acharya. He is crying. Srila Bhakti Ballabh Maharaj, he should take this post. I am not qualified. He is crying and gone to actually Govindakund and crying, I cannot take this post. I am not qualified. Then one Panda, father of Giridhari Panda, I think. He gone, he trace him out and bring him, you will have to go with me. Otherwise, I like to kill myself. You will have to go. Then he come here and is crying and took the responsibility of this Acharya. Throughout his life, whole life, he is doing, his Acharya Siv is so pure. Nobody can speak anything against him. He is my Siksha Guru. He is my Siksha Guru. He is glorifying my Gurudev all the time. You know, this kind of Acharya Siv is rare. He is always staying under the guidance of my Gurudev after his Gurudev gone. As almost non-different from my Gurudev, he is thinking this way. So many points. One point I like to speak, then I like to drop my speech. Actually, Brajamandal Parikrama, you know, Prabhupada in whole life, one time done. After that, Srila Madhava Goswami Maharaj done this Parikrama, long time. And Srila, my Guru Padma used to stay with him. And one day, actually, some devotee expressing dissatisfaction because we are always late for Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj. He is very slow, old man, that's why he cannot go fast. So we like to do complete parikram because we are hungry, sometimes we like to take rest. Then Maharaj become lion, become very angry. You go! Go! You go! I am going to follow my Guru Padma, Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj. I cannot see Brajadham. I like to see Brajadham under the guidance of Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj. He can see everything. Radha Kund, Sam Kund, everything. What you can see? Go and take rest. Take prasadam quickly. Go and take rest. I am not going to violate my rules. This way he is so strict. Every time, if you give 1 inch, if you give same asan with Guru Padma, he is not going to take that asan. No! I cannot take this asan. I must stay down. My Guru Varga, this way I have the chance to learn the Vaishnava etiquette from him. His acharon is very powerful. So I beg for pardon if I have done any mistake. I am praying for full kripa from him. One day in this Gokul Dham, I wrote one letter with resolution. Maharaj, be sure, 100%. I am going to get your 100% kripa. I wrote in one letter. 100%, I promise. I am going to get your full kripa. This way, with resolution, I wrote one letter. So I think he can bestow his full kripa on me. So I beg for pardon to you all. If I have done any mistake, vancha kalpaturvasya kepasindu bhavacha patitanang pavana bhavishna bhyo namo namaha.